looking at, okay, there is this dynamic between the role that we play consciously in society, the way we kind of describe and identify ourselves, this self-concept, and the shadow. Mm-hmm. There's that duality, right? The what we put forth as the things we identify with and what we rejected about ourselves. And Jung would say that shadow element is unconscious. It's running in the mind, but it's running unconsciously, meaning it's below the radar. We're not able to really perceive it in our everyday interaction. And so most people think, the person that triggers me at work, the person that triggers me in my family, the people that I see out there on the internet that I see as bad or evil, they believe those are true. The ordinary person believes the badness, the shadow elements are out there. I can see them in others, but it's not me. Mm-hmm. Whereas Jung is saying, integrating the shadow is morally difficult because of that. Because you have to accept that, the people that I identify as bad or as triggering me, they're really pointing at my own shadow.
Yeah, and not that you are that way, but that you are fearing being that or perceived that way. And what I love about Jung is that he talks about that polarity of, with everything has an other opposite end. So this idea, I remember, my early days of personal growth, is like creating this idealistic me that's all good, all enlightened, all powerful. I got rid of all my negative my baggage from my childhood. And there's this somehow this ideal person that has this perfection. And we can't, if we build that up as our persona, that means the opposite that we push away is the mess. The unevolved person, the reckless person, so we put that in our shadow. So we don't realize that you can't have one side without the other. And what Jung says about integration is that you have to see that you're not the persona or the shadow, that you're something else. And I do feel that sometimes people do shadow work. And even we've seen this happen in people that we've worked with, where they take on the persona and then they push away the shadow. And then they're like, okay, I'm going to integrate my shadow. So they just flip it. And so I'm going to be this badass, bitchy woman, and I'm going to put niceness in my shadow because I've been nice my whole life. So they just swap it, but you're still trying to compensate from the other. And so it's like this duality that we're really trying to, it's like rearranging the furniture. We never really get anywhere because we're just swapping personas. So this episode is really about the brilliance. And, there are a lot of people think that shadow is dark. It's all our negative beliefs. I see so many people misrepresent the shadow, saying it's negative beliefs. It's all the not good enough and stuff. That's not the shadow at all. The shadow is more the it's like more a behavior, psychological, psychic pattern that's much bigger than just thought or belief about yourself. It's more like a whole construction of expression that you can't put out there. So if you believe. So I think when we go into the conditioning socially, we try to regulate ourselves to the group. And so it's that mediocreness that creates that persona shadow. And so when I think about the brilliance, the first thing I think about is what's beyond mediocre? What's that shining light? What's that you becoming successful? You having great love? You having all these amazing things that are different than the construction or the conditioning of your family? That's what I see is the brilliance in the shadow.